The fear of clowns has been discussed as a specific phobia, and the term coulrophobia is a new word and phrase that is still in the process of entering common use, but it's not yet mainstream language. The fear of clowns has been ever-growing throughout the years. Coulrophobia is not listed in the World Health Organization. The fear can cause panic, difficulty breathing, irregular heartbeat, sweating, nausea, not to mention overwhelming feelings of fear. 19-year-old Jordan Parry has suffered from coulrophobia for as long as she can remember. She developed the phobia as a toddler and has had it ever since.
I don't have a specific kind of age in mind when the fear started, but I have a feeling it was around 6 or 7. I broke my arm when I was about 6 or 7. The curtains that they pull around you, because there's just loads of clowns like looking right at me. When I see a clown, I get anxious. I mean, my hands get sweaty. I feel physically sick, and more often than that, I will cry. I'm afraid of the unknown. I don't like mascots, and I don't like people kind of in these kind of costumes. I do have an identical twin sister who has a phobia of clowns, the same as me, and my mum is also like deathly afraid of clowns. I mean, I'm not sure if it's hereditary. I do genuinely 100% think I have coulrophobia. I don't ever want to have to come face to face with it.
But there isn't just Jordan out there with coulrophobia. 50-year-old Vicky believes her daughter Tilly, who's 13 years old, has coulrophobia as well, and she's had it since the age of 2. This just goes to show that you can develop the phobia at any age.
Tilly was probably about 2.5, maybe 2. She was in a pram. So a clown came up to her. And she was just mortified. And this person was like a dead lovely, he was just like so sweet. And he was like so upset that he'd frightened her so much. He was like, oh! And I think like it pushed a balloon in her face. But yeah, he was upset. I think her heartbeat rises. She's truly extremely anxious. She will hide anywhere. She'll just make a beeline away from the person that's dressed as a clown. I believe Tilly is terrified of people dressed as clowns, which is terrifying for me as a mother.
Paul Hill is a registered therapist and a hypnotherapist from Salford in Manchester. Paul specialises in all types of phobias and treats patients with his one-to-one sessions, hypnotherapy, counselling and guided exposure, which is getting the client to a stage where they feel comfortable and ready to face their fears. Paul believes that coulrophobia is out there somewhere, as he demonstrates that this fear is listed in the Book of Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, but it's still not listed as coulrophobia.
Phobias, it's about fear. It's a pronounced fear. And very often an irrational fear. So in terms of what they are, they're based on fear, and we have a survival instinct. All of us, humans and animals, are hardwired, and phobia is a sense of danger. This is what we call ancestral phobias, which is picked up in childhood very often. You know, mum's afraid of cats and that's sort of in the house, and the child sort of breathes that in and they experience that because that's what they hear and experience, and so they adopt that. But when you said fear of clowns, that did register something in me, and I guess the publicity, what's been around that of late. In terms of phobias, it says other type. Children's fears of loud sound and costume characters. So this has been around for a while. So I guess that costume characters may take in clowns. I'm saying perhaps it is sort of maybe listed in a particular way, really. I'm wondering if it is there, but it's hidden under other types of something of that nature.
You can't really say anything to make people understand. I just think if it was listed and it was acknowledged as a genuine kind of health like issue, then people would take it seriously and not kind of mock it.
If somebody is frightened of something, they're frightened of something. If somebody is terrified of something, you can see, feel, hear that in that person. We're all scared about something. We're all scared. Might be you next time. So